So, as everyone know, elephants in nature never dance. But if someone have a lot of patience and time, he can make elephant dancing. And let's see how we can implement this general approach to PostgreSQL. I'm start with a bit about myself and the company where I worked. It's Data Ygritte. Just 1 month ago, Data Ygritte was known as PostgreSQL Consulting. We provide a database maintenance solution, 24/7 consulting, and so on, for medium, small, large clients, whatever. Personally, I work with PostgreSQL for more than 15 years, starting from 2000 years, like ages ago. My main specialization is general database performance optimization, starting from network stack and ending from query optimization, index tuning, PLP GSQL optimization, and so on. Additional MySQL specialization is what I call it emergency database troubleshooting. If something broken really bad and need to be fixed fast, it's usually I'm doing it. Now let's move. So, just 3 minutes ago, you said that elephants doesn't dance. They can be make dancing. So. Really? Yes. In practice, in PostgreSQL and in every other database, some queries cannot be automatically optimized by a database engineer. In that case, implementation of alternative approach, alternative algorithm, can provide really huge performance boost, 10 times, 100 times, 1,000 times, depend on your workload. Of course, not every query can be optimized this way, but in many practical real-world situations, there exists some alternative approach to get required data faster from the database. So, goals of this presentation will be the first, demonstrate some very useful alternative approach to execute queries. The second goal is provide method and ideas of PLP GSQL code conversion to plain SQL queries. And I'm trying to arrange this presentation as self-contained learning package, so it can be used outside of today's presentation as some ready-to-use material. As a result, this presentation contains quite a lot of queries, a lot of text, which I'm not going to read as full, but it will be useful for someone who reads this presentation after. And of course, this presentation has some non-goals. It points which I'm not going to discuss. And the first, it will be not about basic query optimization, because there is a lot of material on internet, on books available about how to optimize your query with indexes and so on. The second, it will be not about query planner and optimizer limitation. It's an independent topic. I'm just show how to solve practical real world problem with practical solution. And third, it's not about compare PLP GSQL code performance with plain, with the same plain SQL queries. This afford me a wrote PLP GSQL code samples, not in the fastest possible way, but in the way which easiest to understand, because it will be, there will be some complicated concepts. It's a very good bonus, I think. This presentation targeted to mostly to SQL developers, and there are some prerequisites which really good to have to understand what's going on. It requires some basic PLP GSQL knowledge. It's very good to have anyway. And knowledge about advanced PostgreSQL features, such as with, recursive, join, lateral, and unnest. Every sample on this presentation was tested on PostgreSQL 9.6, latest available. But it should work on a previous version with minimal modification. If you try to run it on older version, like 9.3 or and older, it's still possible, but it really requires workaround implementation for some missing features. Originally, part of this presentation was presented 4 years ago for very old PostgreSQL version in St. Petersburg in Russia in 2014 years. Since then, it greatly improved and added a lot more additional information. So this presentation arranges as multiple independent blocks. Every block has the same structure. It starts from problem description. Then I show a native approach, simple SQL query, explain analyze where I provide information why it's slow and why it doesn't work fast. Then alternative algorithm implementation on PLPGSQL, where it's a lot easier to analyze algorithm. Then I will provide the same algorithm implemented in plain SQL, just single query, followed by explain analyze, and of course at the end performance result and performance score comparison of all three approaches. Okay, let's start quickly through initial data preparation. I'm not going to concentrate on it a lot, but it's very useful to understand what structure will be. It will be a very simple structure with just two tables. First is block post table with ID, CTime, payload, and author ID. And a secondary table, author table, test table with ID and name. Block post table have a primary key on ID and have unique query index and author ID and CTime. This very simple structure allow me to provide 7 different problems with a different solution, which we're going to discuss. Next few slides are just creation table, required tables, populate table. Someone can analyze it in free time, no magic. But you can run all this query on your computer and check every provided solutions. Continue population table. And now let's move to first practical issue. Using index-only scans to speed up a query using large offsets. So, as everyone who works with PostgreSQL knows that queries with large offsets are almost always slow, whatever you do. It's because to produce 1 million first row, the database is going to iterate through first million rows anyway. However, iteration through the rows require reading database reading from the heap, from the table. But alternatively, we can use try to use a fast index-only scan to skip first million rows. And because index-only scan not go into database table data and read only index, it's supposed to be faster. Let's see. So, very simple query. Select from block post table, order by ID, let's say offset 1 million, limit 10. Let's see how the database executes this query. What we see? The database fetched 1 million and 10 rows using index scan. Using index scan means the database fetching not only data from index, but it fetched also 1 million 10 rows from table itself. And only after it applies limit 10 to produce required result. It means that we need really last 10 rows, but the database go into table and fetch 1 million 10 rows. Of course, it not good for performance. Let's see how we can implement alternative IDE on PLPGSQ. In this case, it's a very simple idea. Initially, we using only select ID with required offset, with limit 1. Because we selecting not all data from the table, but only ID, it can use the index-only scan and skip offset rows. So in this case, database will through first 1 million rows using index-only scan rows and not go into the table itself. When we found starting ID, we can fetch required limit amount of the rows from the database itself using normal index scan. But it will run only for limit rows. In PLPG scale, this look very simple. So let's try implement the same idea using PlainSQL query. In PlainSQL, I'm using the literal. Initially, I'm selecting again starting ID. Absolutely, using absolutely the same approach, just converted to SQL. Starting from selecting starting ID and using lateral join to fetch required 10 rows only. Of course, such query needs to be make a manual. No ORM or automatic query generation will provide you with this approach. Now let's see, does it really help or not? Because for every such idea, you should test, does it really provide performance benefit or not? So, completely forgot about explain analyze. Explain analyze of fast query version. See that database uses index-only scan for scan through 1 million rows and then switching to index scan to fetch required 10 rows. So it's supposed to be fast. Let's see. What we can see? For small offsets, we have like 2-time difference in performance. So advanced SQL version almost 2 times faster. As offset get bigger, performance difference get bigger as well. And for big offsets, there is a 4-time performance difference between native SQL version and advanced SQL version. Not great, but 4-time difference means that your web page or report will run at 3 or 4 times faster. And or you need four times less hardware for the same task. So with minimal query changes, we make real world query 3 to 4 times faster. Okay, let's move to second optimization case. As I said, every block independent from each other. It just show interesting idea how you can speed up real world situation. This part I'm call pull down limit under join condition. If a query have combination of join, order by, and limit case, and database switch to sort plan. The database will join first and sort all final results and provide only limit rows at the end. However, we don't. If you have foreign key, you don't need a join for rows which not will get into result final result. Yes, so in many cases it will be very a lot more efficient perform limit plus order by part, and then only after join required tables to result. So, native query look again, pretty normal for everyone who works with this key. Select from block post table, join all sort table, some author ID condition, order by CTime, limit 10%. Simplest query which demonstrates the problem. Let's see how to the database execute this query. We can see that database starts from fetching 50,000 rows from block post table. And then for every rows, it's joining author table, performing inner loop for 50,000 times. And only after the database performs sort to return 10 required rows. Of course, we need author information about authors only for these rows. We don't need all 50,000 authors in this case. So, how we can implement alternative idea in PLPGScale where it's easier to do? Let's start from selecting required amount of rows from block post table, applying sort and limit before we're going to join with all sort table. So for table results in this query, we limiting result to only 10 rows, and then only for final rows, we perform join this result from with author table. Let's see this in PLPGScale. It's quite easy to understand what's going on. So let's try convert this query to plain SQL version. Again, we are using two literal construction with the same queries. So, again, we selecting order by CTime limit 10 and using literal join. Sorry. And using literal join to join author info. Second order by required because the database can decide use some alternative plan and was the initial ordering. So what I want to show is that for this kind of query in PLPGScale can be converted to the same query in plain SQL using literal construction. So you start from initial query and use a literal construction for loop body. Let's see how the database executes this query. We can see, so the database again fetched 50,000 rows from block post table. It doing sort and limit, and only after it did sort and limit, it joined all sorts only 10 times instead of 50,000 times. Let's see, does it really help or not? For situation with only 5 authors and limit 10. Native SQL run 150 milliseconds, and advanced SQL version run 3 times faster. If you, let's say, have a join not with only author table, but you have like 5 more table joined by say in the same situation, performance difference will be a lot more. So in many practical cases, if a join condition just used to provide additional information, it might be a lot more efficient to perform a query with order by limit first and then only after join required row as a tables. In practical situation, I've seen more than 10 times difference between native and advanced approach when there are a lot more join involved. It again stop using the database as a big white box, which no better than developer what to do. But apply alternative manual idea, which can produce a great performance benefit. Okay, let's move for the next block. This book should be known for someone because it published on a wiki page and available in the internet in many places. But still, it again shows the same idea using of alternative approach. So I'm talking about speed up distinct query. Every developer finds in their life sometime, the distinct query of a large table always slow. Because it always scans whole table, even if it looks for 100 unique ID, it will scan 100 million rows if there are 100 million rows in table. Alternative, it's a creative user index and query to perform distinct calculation. This technique known as loss index scan and not a good description available on PostgreSQL wiki page. So, in native or simple form, query look like this one. Select distinct author ID from blog post page. Let's see how the database runs this query. We can see the database scanned a whole 10 million rows of the table to produce only 1,000 unique authors. Of course, scanning 10 million rows cannot be fast. Now let's see how we can implement loss index scan using only PLPGSQL. We're starting from selecting minimal author ID from table. It, if you have index on author ID, it will run really fast. And then, for every perform a loop and look for the next author ID bigger than one which we already found, and returning author's ID in result. As result, the database we found minimal author ID, then using index we going to find the next author ID after this one, which is again really, really fast, because query with such conditions using index very efficient. And let's see how we can convert this query into plain SQL form. Well, in this case, because inside the loop we modify some variables, we cannot use a simple join lateral approach. We switching to with recursive, which allow us perform iteration with changed variables inside the loop. So again, we starting from last author ID, so it's actually the same query. And then doing with recursive loop, you're using again join literal construction to select next author ID bigger than found on previous iteration. And finally, return found values. Query look very complicated, but if you start from PLP GSQL version and debug there, convert to this version, pretty straightforward actually. And let's see how the database runs this query. So, in this case, the database starts from looking for minimal author ID here, and then perform 1000 loop over index, fetching next author ID. It's supposed to be faster. Let's see, does it really faster or not? Well, what we can see? Almost 3 seconds on native SQL for 10 million table, but 10 milliseconds for advanced SQL version. So it almost 300 time difference. So this speed means that you have a page unresponsive. This speed means that you can use this approach in many situations. So again, alternative algorithm provides huge performance benefit. Okay, let's move to the next. The next block I'm called calculate distinct on with in list. Distinct on within uses when application require fetch the latest data for some selected list in single query. Like you have 10 authors and would like to find latest post from each of these authors. Distinct on usually slow, unfortunately, in the database. And again, we try to use creative indexes and advanced query technique to calculate, to speed up this query. So in native SQL or simple implementation, this query look like, again, a very distinct on author ID, from block post table, where author ID sum list, order by author ID, cetera. This query should provide 5 rows with the latest post for each of listed author ID. Let's see how the database runs this query. What we can see, the database fetched all posts from this listed authors, so it fetches from the table 50,000 rows, and then starts sorting and unique query. It's not really efficient, unfortunately. What we can try? In PLP GSQL, let's say we're iterating over author ID array, and for every author ID we perform one single query. Select from a block post table where author ID, some author order by ctime, limit 1. If we have an index on author ID and ctime, this query will again run very fast. Now, after we debugged a new idea, we can try implement the same idea using a plain SQL version, plain SQL. In this case, because no variable changes inside a loop, we can switch back to normal literal construction. So, We starting from array of authors, and for each of authors, the run the same query as here, as we tested on PHP GSkill version. So it will loop over these five authors, and perform a query for one query for each of them. Let's see does it how the database executes this query. Of course, in every explain, I'm show only critical part of explain, because you don't want to see five pages of explain analyze for every sample. For this page, in this explain analyze, we see that the database performing only five index only scan, each index scan, one index scan for each of authors. And now let's see if that's really help for our case or not. Well, native SQL run 110 milliseconds. Advanced SQL run 0.4 milliseconds, so we again have more than 200 performance difference between basic and advanced approach. And again means that for this case, the database will be not really fast. For this situation, it's no performance issue at all. I'm just want to say is this all timing was performed on Amazon EC2 large memory instance, so all the database in the memory, in just shared buffers. So I'm not worried about disk performance issue or disk access time. Okay, we have only two blocks left, and every block will be more complicated than previous. So it's getting interesting, I hope. Now let's suppose we need this calculate distinct on not over some author list, but over all the table, whole the table. When distinct on start used, when you start only developing your application, distinct on work perfect. But once your table grow, the data distinct on query become performance issue quite fast. From my experience, distinct on large tables is always performance killer and no go for web page. It even no go for online reporting. So, what we can try if we need calculate distinct on of a really big table. So, initial native query looks simpler than previous. Distinct on author ID from block post table. Ordered by author ID ctime. As we have 1,000 of unique authors, it should provide 1,000 rows. However, let's see how the database producing this 1,000 rows. Oops, it's problem. The database start again scanning all 10 million rows. Then it using disk to sort 10 gigabytes of the data. External disk merge, 10 gigabytes of data, of course, performance will be awful. And in final, it produces only 1,000 rows. Not good at all. Let's see what we can do with this problem. This is a bit more complicated situation, of course. But we again starting from greatest author ID and in the same time fetch the latest query, latest post from this author. Again, if we have index on author ID and ctime, this query will run very fast. Then we will use a bit more complicated query inside the loop. which select the latest post from next following out already. So actually it slight modification of distinct quick distinct query which we discussed in block form. And again, if we have index on author ID and C time, this query will run really, really fast. And after after we debugged and this version, we can try convert storable procedure to plain SQL query if you don't like storable procedure by some reason. And again, because there is a changes of loop variable inside the loop, unfortunately, we cannot use a jar join lateral and again forced to use it with the recursive construction. Start from the the same query. And then do iterate over the same query. So it's actually that's pretty straightforward conversion of already written PLP GSQL code to plain SQL. And let's see what how the database runs. We can see the database you performed 1,000 index scan to fetch all required data. No more it read all 10 million rows from the table. This time I will provide one alternative approach to this idea. We can, using five distinct auto-ID calculation, which we discussed on part four, and then using this five distinct result to implement algorithm from block five. So we joined block 4 and block 5 but to produce the same result. It's a bit easier actually understand what's going on here, but it's a bit slower, but it shows that you can combine every of this approach if you query requires it. And let's see performance difference. Well, 4 seconds. For native SQL approach. For advanced SQL, 13 milliseconds. Sorry, automatically switched to Russian. 13 milliseconds, so we have, again, like 300 time difference. And you cannot use a query with this performance on web pages. But this performance quite good. Now we're going to switch most interesting part of presentation. I'm spent like 3 weeks attempt to make idea of this block easier to understand, and because it will be unusually complicated algorithm, but very practical query. So. Basic new feed look very simple. You have you subscribe it for some authors, let's say 10 authors, and would like to see 10 latest posts. Not for latest post for each author, but the latest post from all authors as full. Like a new friend list in Facebook. The latest post. Well, query look like easy to right, but it's very hard to run fast if the database is really big. So, very common query for many web applications from my experience. It usually has some more conditions, but general structure stays the same. Author ID in some subscribed author list, ordered by CTime, some limit, some maybe some offset. Let's see how the database runs it. Well, the database again fetch all posts from all listed authors, and then start sort 50,000 rows to produce a final 40. Not good, of course, from performance-wise, performance point of view. So, this query fetch all posts from all listed authors. If the database work for 10 years, there will be huge posts from many authors. Problem number two, it fetch whole rows, not only author ID and CTime, but all payload, including work, post text, and so on, increasing memory consumption. The more posts will be in the database, the slower will be query. The longer list of subscribed author used, the slower will be query. No good at all. An ideal implementation for such query should require no more than limit plus offset index probes on in work post table. And ideally it should be fast for at least for small offset and limit values like 100, 1000. It's unlikely someone go past last 100 page of list. So, let's start from array of author ID. So, array of, let's see, we subscribe to after 20, 10, 30, 160. So, we have an array of this structure. And this just position of rows into array. And now, using ideas from block 5, which we already discussed, populate the second array of the latest post for each of listed authors. It actually the same queries which we discussed in block 5. So now we have the second array with the dates of the latest posts. And now, let's select position of the latest post on second array. So in this case, it will be position 4, end of February. So we this array query for this one, for this task. So now we have position 4 for the latest post at all. Let's fetch this row into final result. So we found the first row, the latest post of all from these authors. It will be author ID 4 and the CTime of this one. And replace this value with the date of the previous post of the same author. So we just select previous post from the same author that is queried. Now just rinse and repeat previous two steps. So select the latest post from this table, from this array. In this case, it will be this rows in position 5 for after 16 and push it into result table. Then rinse and repeat to previous step. On each iteration, populate found results. Well, algorithm looks easy, but as implementing this algorithm on a scale, not going to be easy. So even in a PLPG scale, it look a bit scary. So this is just populate this array, this part. Then until we found required rows, we're doing step 2, and then step 3. And then if we already skipped the offset rows, we start returning required results. And if and of course increase of counter of found row. And replace the time of author ID with previous message time. So actually it just a straightforward implementation of what we did discuss it on this slide. I really recommend spend 10 or 20 minutes after analyze of this idea. Now let's try implement the same complicated, really this really complicated algorithm for PlainSQL in a PlainSQL version. Final query look like this one. Don't be scared. We will split into the part and quickly go through the it. Structure was very simple. So again, we're using with recursive to iteration, initial part of recursive algorithm, our loop of and exit condition, and produce a final result, of course. Initial part look like, well, we have empty results so far, we have zero rows found so far, we have author ID, which we use it in every, okay, to 3 moments. And populate time array. Then it's main loop. Unfortunately, I have a very limited time.
Sorry. Five more minutes.
Okay. So if we already found skipped rows, we start returning results. Increase row found, pass through array of author ID, replace the time inside author to time array, and well, just combination two lateral query to perform all calculation which we have debugged and produced in PLP GSQL. And that's the performance result. With this 10 authors. If you are looking just for one entry, result will be 180 milliseconds, but alternative approach 150 times faster. And for almost many situations, alternative approach faster from 200 times to 60 times. The more offset of limit will be, the less will be difference between approach. So this approach very efficient for limit of offset around not more than 1,000 or maybe 10,000. However, we for most real situation like limit 10 offset 10, there is like 100 times difference. Because this kind of query very, very popular on almost every project. And in almost every project I see a problem with such queries. This approach can be very useful. Okay, so now just some final notes. Efficient execution of some really popular real world query really require implementation of alternative algorithm. In the same time, implementation of custom algorithm a lot 100 times easier when you start using PLP GSQL because it's more like procedural language. And but in the same time, the same algorithm implemented in SQL usually run faster. 2 times, 3 times, 50% faster. And maybe by some reason you just don't like storable procedures. So, the ideal process, if you have idea of either alternative algorithm, you should implement and debug this algorithm in PLP GSQL, and then just convert it to PlainSQL query and check does it really help. Thank you very much for listening to me. I hope mine not explode. Yes, if you have question. Yes,
we have time for questions.
No?
We have some time for questions.
Yeah, okay.
It's not really a question anyway. It's more like I found this quite shocking and depressing actually, because I thought you only need to handhold the query optimizer in such a way if you have a complex query. But you were showing single table queries, like one of them was literally, give me the value of unique values of an index column, right?
Yes.
And then you show that Postgres cannot do it. Is that really, I mean, I'm shocked.
Remember I started with non-goals of presentation. It's not about limitation of query optimizer.
Yeah, but this is not a limitation, I mean.
Yes, it's...
Give me distinct values, index columns,
it's limitation. But I don't expect, we'll make a patch to implement algorithm in from block 7, because it's really complicated.
The last one I understand, maybe, okay, but the previous examples, why doesn't it just work? And more really, is it really the case? I mean,
well, I'm trying to solve real world issue with a real world database, and because client have a real world performance issues. I can discuss why some features implemented or not into the core. Sorry. PostgreSQL is a really great database, but of course every database have some limitation and there is some query which the database cannot run efficiently.
Yeah, but the query like this?
Well, it's not that easy actually. Yeah.
Well, I would like to add to your comment. I've been using Oracle, right, and for my application. And the gentleman is quite right. When you are introducing joins, things get weird, right?
No, there's no joins. If I can take it on this example, index column, give me the distinct values in this index column. How can that go wrong?
Yeah, but the other one, right?
If I recall right, it was with a bare class. It was distinct, and he had an order by. If we can just go back to the first query, it had an order by. That order by included one more column. When you do that, your order by is going to get executed first. So that means your data has to be ordered as per some other column, and distinct has to be out of some other column.
No, I'm not criticizing. I'm really.
I understand. There is, of course, space
to improve PostgreSQL optimizer. See. But you work with current query database, which currently available, with a current project, which doesn't work really fast because there is problem. I'm just show how to can fix this problem.
It's less about Postgres. It's about logic.
Yes.
If I tell you, try to get me distinct names ordered by their date of birth. Now, that is not a simple distinct.
Yep.
Oh, was it like that?
Can you just go back to the first query? So it was ordered by two columns, if I recall correctly.
Yeah. Distinct only, you mean?
No, before that. I think it was really giving me the distinct also.
Which one?
You talk about technically, yes, it could be this algorithm. Actually, I think the first block two optimization, block three optimization, block four optimization could be implemented into executor. But, well, welcome to provide patch.
You know, I mean, really, and if I have to hand code this query, why do I need to use SQL at all? I mean,
so what was the plan for you? Sorry, maybe I missed it. What is the plan you got for this one?
I agree. Well, index on the scan, but all the data.
So he tries to get the max value,
yep.
Right?
Oh,
and then
yep.
Compare with the...
Yes, and then look for previous author.
Yep.
Okay, and if you go back...
And
so
then you have the plan for this also, right?
Yes.
Yeah, do you have a plan for this as well?
Yep.
And it's a like loop of 1,000?
Yes.
Okay. That's pretty impressive because when I looked at the first plan, I thought, what is going to be better than that? Because honestly, that is one of the most optimal plans in most of the RDBMS. Index-only scan.
Yes.
Is one of the most optimal plans in any RDBMS.
Well, it should be a scan. It should be like a skip scan.
Well, should be.
Yeah.
it seems like it's, I understand you have a, okay, maybe you have two tables and not join and you can.
Well, it, all my work, it's work around about some hardware limitation, database limitation, software limitation, developer limitation. Well, it's
fine. I'm really depressed now.
Well, it's just one place where the database could be improved. There is a million other places where the database could be improved as well.
From his perspective, he's just saying, like, why optimizer can't do the same thing which you have done?
Theoretically, yes, but no one have time to implement
it. This is an interesting thing. You should put it up on the mailing list. You should hear what Tomlin has to say about it.
I know what he said about it. Sorry.
Okay.
I'm discussing, so it's a maybe it will be get implemented someday.
Just a small.
Sorry, I thought you were talking about the other query which had this thing. I had not looked at this one at all.
But still, it's like surprising that like when he does that in the PG SQL, how it is improving. Like because again he's doing min, which is like again you have to find out the min value, which needs to be again has to go through the environment.
Yep.
Oh, min doesn't have to go through entire index.
Yeah, min just set one row from index.
Min
it's very good.
To go through.
So that's the point. You're just reversing it.
Yeah.
A pretty smart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it can be implemented.
More can be yes or no question.
Yeah.
There is no physical limitation why this cannot be implemented inside the PostgreSQL. Mm. But you have a project at this moment, and even if you're going to sponsor some development, you will not get result faster than in the next realized cycle.
We'll put it up on SlideShare. And,
yes, it will be available, of course.
We'll also post it somewhere in Postgres mailing list. I hope people take note of it. And from what I know, Postgres SQL Company does take note of feedback and inputs, so you will be heard in one or the other way.
Yep. Okay, thank you very much for listening. I hope it will be not too boring. It was not too boring.